could work.
Who calls massive these day? Nan Gufgrish of Dalor. Your nervous gait betrays your presence, stranger. You don't belong here. Who are you? Blackaith! Why? Your presence imperils us all. If any of us attempts to escape, our kin will die. The Overseers, they have a contraption. When triggered, it will kill everyone who wears a collar. You underestimate the enemy. The Overseers, they are Glixbran Rakthar. The collars are not only equipped with explosives. There is also a mechanism that alerts the Overseers if they're removed. One of us may be able to save themselves, but it would be at the expense of everyone else. We can't risk it. Even if we did somehow unshackle our collars simultaneously and overthrow our oppressors, there would be consequences. Our families are held elsewhere. The Overseers need only activate those contraptions they hold, and they suffer the consequences of our actions too. We cannot win. We must aid in building these Vagrun. Gun-Gull. Aye. Even more, I'd help you destroy this place. I don't know where they are, but some of the Overseers must. You'll have to infiltrate deeper into the Foundry. Just make sure you don't get caught. If they raise the alarm, they'll trigger the collars. I will pray for you. My daughter... her name is Obinia. Gondralfrakas Hulnish. May Gond be with you. Patience. It hasn't been long.
Scared and miserable, with visible cuts and bruises, these people can only be one thing. Prisoners.
Damn, it's good to be alive.
Let's have some courage.
Dear Karlak.
I've missed this.
choice but to keep going.
last.
It seems the father issues are only just beginning, eh? The choice is made. You'll never stop killing. Shh, or I'll rush off and tell your father you've been fibbing. Did he spank you growing up? Or go straight for the Cato 9?
I've got a long road ahead.
Burn yourself. So that's progress.
Watch your back.
Don't be shy.
Wretched thing. Pull yourself together.
Breathing, despite everything.
Deal with the bodies. If I hide the corpses, the smell will attract someone.
So much blood. Those of them.
Ow.
You don't have permission to be here. You're about to be ejected.
Halt, citizen. This is a restricted area.
Aren't you the intrepid little adventurer, digging and diving where you don't belong? And I thought we were friends. Wrong. Your presence here is the only real threat to their survival. Dead, they're no use to me, so I keep them safe, after a fashion. I have prepared for this eventuality, and if you interfere, I will destroy the Iron Throne. Return to the city, find Orin, and claim her Netherstone as you agreed to do. And then I will forget this transgression.
Your conscience pricks. You did agree to an alliance, after all. But then again, what honor need there be with someone like Gortash? Your mind turns to the Gondian hostages, bound in fear, their futures hanging by a thread in Gortash's web.
That was a mistake. When the corpses start to wash up on the shore, remember, you could have prevented all of this. Thank you.
take you first.
With haste.
Nothing will stand in my way.
Yeah.
make it.
First step is the hardest. Boots have seen everything. Now this is my happy place. Their noses. One day I'll catch a break. Got it.
Just a little more to go. Come on!
my way.
Let's cook with fire, baby. Calmness greets you as the submersible slows to a halt. Unlike the Iron Throne, you remain intact. The same cannot be said for most of Gortash's hostages. Duke Ravengard approaches you, looking confused.
He's tackled, but under my protection now, just like you. His mind is his own again.
I'm free. In my own mind again, holy. I will not take it for granted. You have my gratitude, friend. You acted quickly, decisively. No soul who fell here did so in vain. I will honor their sacrifice. My thoughts are my own now. And my purpose certain. I will wait at your camp. We can speak more there.
So we made it! We actually... Our savior! Please, I want to ask you something!
Still hurts, but thank you. What they were doing with us was horrid. Thank you for saving me.
Things have stayed interesting.
You have beaten and tormented us to the brink of insanity. You cut out my eyes. But we will bow no more. Gondians! Rip the motivator from this bastard's hands! For Gond! What happened to Obelia? Is she safe? My heart. I thought her lost. I would give more than just my sight to keep her safe. Our destination is the Neurositor, the nerve center of the Steel Watch. Guide me there, and I'll do the rest. fellow Gondians, flee this prison. We're bringing this place down.
Sounds like fun.
Fight against progress. I will not allow it.
Prince's motivation sequence activated. Prince's motivation system activated.
Ah! Warning. Sequence trigger imminent.
Invenium. river. Shoot them back.
Close. So close to being free. But it was all for naught. My friends, my fellow Gondians, they're dead. Burned alive from the inside out. You must finish this. Destroy the foundry. End the Steel Watch. Can I have no peace? Fine. Let us move swiftly before I change my mind.
Counted my footsteps correctly, this door leads to the Foundry's gates and the new officer.
Death and decay.
We're near cadaver preparation, aren't we?
Poor bastards are shipped in from all over the realms. Most come from a fellow called Balthazar, by way of Moonrise Powers.
The inscription reads, "Fresh supplies for the Steel Watch, courtesy of Necromancer Balthazar." The brain in this jar is controlling a watcher on sentry duty at Worm's Rock. It patrols back and forth, vigilant for trouble. This jar is aware that its watcher is on duty in the control center, vast and throbbing with illithid telepathy. It ignores your mind touch as a mere distraction.
Breathing, despite everything.
Looking ahead.
We need to move. Wait. Elevator gyroscopes. Triples a quadrupex. No, it can't be. I hear it through the floor. Powerful, indestructible. The ultimate watcher. The Titan.
Sounds like a challenge.
It shames me to admit this, but you must face this beast of Gondian folly alone. I would be crushed in an instant. When it raises its shields, strike it with every scrap of magic and might you possess, and pray to Gon that it does not fire upon you. Good luck, my friend.
Don't be shy. Hey, good looking.
Mind never quiet.
Easy, does it?
How many die today? How many die tomorrow?
Moment.
days.
Never a dull moment. Come on, can't stay idle. Blood comes easy these days.
Over here.
again. Survival is all that matters. Time for some bloody work. Is ever easy. Can't even catch my breath. Don't waste a step. Thank you.
The Neurositor. I can hear its hum. Familiar, yet painful. I helped design the steel watches, toiled night and day on the first bipedal prototype. It is fitting it ends this way. I will bring down not only the steel watch, but the very foundry itself. This place will be smoke and rubble when I am finished. Are you ready, my friend? Like the foundry, the Neurositor's exterior is near impossible to penetrate. However, its inner circuitry is highly unstable. I'm going to rain fire upon it from the inside out. Gond, let your hammer be my courage, your furnace my heart.
That was a hell of a show, my friend. Watchers collapse in the street as we speak. And the foundry. Well, it won't stain this beautiful city with its abominations. Not anymore. But it's not over. So long as a single parasitic Gondian remains, Baldur's Gate is under threat.
Wolburn, enough. The Gondians are no more. I am all that is left. Take the city. Let the Iron Hands reign supreme. I just wish to go home and mourn my daughter in peace. He'll never find us. We have safe houses all over the city. We are no threat. I swear it.
Please. If a Gondian told me the sky was blue, I'd look outside and check. Tubin will lie, torment, and scheme until his dying breath. Kill him, or the Iron Hands will.
Wolbrin, enough! I won't watch as you poison your soul and the brilliant future that remains to the Iron Hand gnomes. I thought the Iron Hand gnomes had corrupted you, Wolbrin. Now, I wonder if it wasn't the other way around. Kill Tubin, and you kill all we love. Collaboration, challenge, solving problems with the power of reason, creativity, and invention. I still want to believe you're better than that, Wolbrin. But even I am having my doubts. I say you're right. They deserve a leader who'll encourage them to create, not destroy. They deserve someone like me. I can't save you from yourself, Wolbrin. It hurts terribly, but I can't. Toss your values in the bin if you want, but don't throw out the Iron Hands with them.
This is ridiculous. Iron Hands, kill this man.
How dare you? Cowards!
The Gondians recognize Barkus Root as leader of the Iron Hand gnomes and look forward to ushering in a new peace between our factions.
It is with a heavy heart that I remove Wulbryn Bongle from our ranks. You have until first light to leave the city. Wulbryn.
I expect treachery from all sides, but you, little Barkus, the boy who followed me from the Underdark, who clung to me like moss to stone, when we next meet, my hammer will cleave your skull in two, and that is a promise.
I'll feel that one later.
Well, here we are. A most unexpected outcome. I am many things. A leader is not one of them. But no time like the present to learn. And I can't do any worse than Wulbryn, sorry as I am to say it. I don't know when he became so angry, so violent. But I'm glad to say I see the truth of it now. At last. Thank you for your encouragement. I needed it. And have done since the day we met. I may have lost Wulbryn, but I found a far preferable ally. Friend, even. Now, myself and the Iron Hand gnomes have much to disentangle. But when you're ready to face what's waiting for you, believe me, we will be at your side. shoo then, for now, my friend.
It is not in a Githyanki's nature to say thank you. Our language doesn't even have a phrase for it. Kraith Khan Jan is the closest equivalent I know. May your enemies know agony. But after releasing me from Orin's grip, there is only one proper response. Thank you. Sincerely. Well...
First you cleave my heart in twain, now you shatter it to pieces. My son, a monster. Twisted beyond recognition. To think my blood flows through those veins. Is this my fate? To be freed from Gortash's hell, only to be trapped in yours?
It isn't what you think. It never was.
You turned your back on me, on your city. to chase the she-devil and her power. She stinks up the place even now. It is exactly what I think.
Ravenguard's tadpole clenches as your memories and wills flow into him.
By Tyr's wounds, I'm in your mind.
The Grand Duke sees Mizora and her infernal sisters. He sees the agony in Will's face as an impossible choice is set before him.
No. My son.
The past becomes present, and Will's thoughts are laid bare. Ravenguard sees Will partnering with Mizora to defeat Tiamat's cultists before they could lay siege to Baldur's Gate, and he sees everything beyond. The Nautiloid journey, the perilous path to Moonrise, the astral prism, and the Emperor within.
Will.
Everything I did for Baldur's Gate. I did for you.
My son, you sold your soul to save Baldur's Gate, and I cast you out for it. You gave yourself to the Hell's eternal fire so I might walk free. By the gods, can you ever forgive me?
There's nothing to forgive. You wanted to protect the city. I only ever wanted the same.
You are a better man than most, and a better son than I deserve. I'll yet make amends, but my duty is first and foremost to the city and its people. There's something I must ask of you. Before I was captured, I was on a mission. Returning from Alterel, I discovered the plans of the Absolutists. I immediately realized the city couldn't defend itself against such an army. I didn't despair, because the city has a secret guardian, a worm that sleeps beneath. He can be called upon in times of great need. This is such a time. You've been trained in the ways of the great champions and proven to be one of them. The worm will answer your call. You must seek him out. A bronze dragon, yes. He sleeps beneath us even now, awaiting a hero to rouse him. The worm goes by many names. Ansur, the waiting storm, the heart of the gate. He promised Baldurin he'd protect the city if ever its existence was threatened, but just the once. Since then, the city has faced countless threats, but we always overcame. There was never a need to call on the worm. Until now, the Absolute is the greatest threat Baldur's Gate ever faced. The worm must be awakened, and the task falls to you. Take this. The legend of Ansur. An ancient epic, ill-remembered, dismissed as a mere tale. Let it set the path before you. Thank you. And may the city know the truth of my only son. Pride of Ravenguard. Pride of Baldur's Gate.
We'll finish what my father couldn't. We'll awaken Ansur, the heart of the gate. I disappointed him once. I won't do it again.
Go on,
Read The Legend of Ansur. Then we can plan our next steps. It's complicated. There's the joy of reconciliation, the relief of forgiveness, and the anxiety of new expectation. It's a flurry of emotion. I'm not sure how to make sense of it. Expectation. A duke's son is forever blessed and cursed to carry his banner. I will be his champion. I will be his pride. I will be the man he taught me to be. Once all this is ended, once we've crushed the brain and freed the people, I could once more call Baldur's Gate home. Whether I return there, well, only time will tell.
Sora is still in the Wurmsbrock prison. But what's this of a true hero's spark?
Of course they do.